In 2020, the global COVID-19 pandemic forced us all to make drastic changes to our lives. For many of us, this meant more time at home with family, and in many cases, much more time in the kitchen preparing meals for the ones we love. Though we cannot gather together in person this year for Fall Fete, we can come together as a community and remember the mission that brings us together, to support the work of the Foundling and the tens of thousands of people who are reached by its programs every year. We hope this cooking program reminds us all of the community around us, and that even when we can't be together in person, our hearts can still bring us together around the table. From all of us, enjoy and bon appetit.
First up, here's Chef Mark Bailey.
He's a chef to the stars, former contestant on Chopped, and cookbook author. Please welcome Mark Bailey.
I was in corporate America for years, and I decided to do something completely different with my life. And then Chef Bailey was born.
Mark Anthony Bailey. He's here to share some quick, sweet, easy recipes.
It's interactive foods, I call them in my book.
Scones. You want to use your hands to kind of crumble the butter up in there?
Edamame. You know I love spice.
We're doing some apple Belgian waffles. You know it's
Gouda.
Oh, Gouda.
As in good. As in really good.
Yeah, it is fried. Gouda.
Yeah, zest always really, really helps, like any kind of fried goods.
Mm-hmm. It brightens it.
Exactly. Coconut oil as well as some jerk seasoning.
Jerk wings as well.
Strawberry jam as well as lemon zest. That's delish.
You know, I've never had a moist scone in my life.
Really?
This is a moist. Yeah, you know, they're normally dry.
The recipe is
this
in my cookbook.
This is really good.
Your book, Cooking in Boxers. We've been trying to convince you to cook in boxers on our show. What do we have to do?
Yeah, I'm out here naked.
Yeah. Can we get more of a full shot?
This is my stick.
Cooking without your clothes on really adds to the effect.
It is fried.
Chef Mark Bailey.
Chef Mark Bailey.
Chef Mark Bailey.
Celebrated chef.
Chef Mark Bailey.
Chef Mark Bailey.
This is your specialty.
This is my season.
Please welcome Mark Bailey.
Please welcome. That's
what I'm celebrated.
Yes.
And cookbook author Mark Anthony Bailey.
Welcome, everyone. Welcome to New York Foundling's Fall Fete. And as you know, this year we're going all things virtual for 2020. So I'm your host for this cooking demonstration. I'm Chef Bailey, and today we're going to be making a delicious sausage pasta with pumpkin and Parmesan cream sauce. One of the reasons I love this dish, number one, it's October, so tis the season for all things pumpkin. And I love this dish because we're entering into comfort season. So, you know, pasta, cheese, all speaks to me as far as comfort. And my third reason for loving this dish, it's quick and easy. We'll get it done in under 45 minutes or less. So hey, let's get started. First things first, let's get the ingredients going. But before you start that, I want you to get a pot of boiling water. Just in case you're cooking along with me, I want you to get a pot going on the stove with some boiling water for our pasta. And then I'll go over all of the things with you right now that you'll need for this dish. First things first, your pasta of choice. I went with bowtie. You can obviously go with penne if you like. Whatever your pasta love is. I like bowtie. It's kind of like a little pretty pasta, and it looks well as far as presentation. Sausage, you can go with turkey sausage, you can go with your Italian sweet, or if you want a little extra kick, you can go with spicy as well. So we're going to take these out of the casings in a little bit. I'll walk you through that. Pumpkin puree, of course. This is what we're using all season long for anything from cakes to pasta, and you'll see. Parmesan, we have some grated Parmesan here. And once again, you can get all the measurements, you'll be able to get the recipe online. We're going to have the shallots. We're going to go with shallots. You can go with onions as well. Shallots tend to be a little bit sweeter, you know, we like to use these a lot of times in soups. And then about 2 to 3 garlic cloves. For garnish at the end, you're probably going to need a little extra more Parmesan cheese. We'll have a little parsley diced up there, as well as some red pepper flakes, again, if you like that spice. And then we're going to need a little oil, 2 tablespoons olive oil at most, and salt for taste. And then we're also going to use our half and half. This is what's going to make it nice and creamy when we pull it all together. So let's get started. First things first, let's get that pasta going. And we're gonna cook this for about 7 to 8 minutes al dente per your package instructions. So let's get that boiling. In the meantime, let's get working on our sausage. casings here. Tablespoon of oil in the pan. We got it on medium high heat, and we're gonna just put our sausage in there and let that start frying up. Start getting a sizzle, and we'll break that down. Now we're gonna get our shallots diced up and get that prepared so that once the sausage is done, we can go right to sauteing our shallots and garlic.
My mom wanted to put me somewhere where I was safe.
After having my four children, I wanted to have that fulfillment of finishing my education.
I said, you know what? I can't be in a gang. Something had to really change my life.
They like really made me feel like I was at home, and I just loved it.
Have a 150-year history of being responsive and accountable to our neighbors. You need a community around you, and Foundling operates in that. We're a family.
We empower children, adults, and families. We sit down and we talk to them and say, hey, what are your goals? What are your strengths? What are your weaknesses? How can I help you?
The real success for me is when they move on, they seek out opportunities where they can be forces of positive change.
If we focus on the four pillars, that people get to choose where they live, they connect to their community, they have relationships and good health, then, you know, our job is done.
There is potential in every single person. We impact communities and thus impact families, which in turn makes a difference in every child's life.
We have to have a future, and it all depends on us. We can't change what's in the past, but as long as we have time, we can change the future.
If we can intervene in one generation, the likelihood that any of their family members return to the same social status is reduced dramatically.
They be helping me since day one. I end up having everything on my own, working, doing the best I can.
I didn't know I was going to fight the cancer, you know. And all the staff was with me, and they guide me, and they helped me through it together.
Family is key. If we prepare to be good role models for our children, you become a better family.
I think that the Foundling for the next 20, 30, 40 years will continue to focus more on family-based and community-based care. This is a rich, rich place. $5 in a cradle in 1869. 25 years later, over 24,000 children had passed through the sisters' care. And so the sisters had always prided themselves in not only responding to the needs of the day, but anticipating the needs of tomorrow. We don't have all the answers, but we think we've asked an awful lot of the questions.
There's definitely hard moments, but as long as you get the help you need, you can always achieve.
We're gonna let this cook first and then we're gonna break it up. Cool thing about this is you can use sausage, you can use chicken, you can use shrimp if you'd like. So you can switch up the protein in this dish. It's really, really easy and simple. A boneless chicken breast would be great. Yeah. We'll just make this cook. Transfer this out of the pan to a separate bowl. Oh, and we want to use the same pan. We're going to return this back to the stove. Reduce our heat to a little medium-low. We will add an additional tablespoon or so of olive oil. Shallots to the pan. And I like to use a zester just to zest the garlic in there, but if you don't have a zester, that's fine. You can always just dice it, mince it really, really finely, and add that in there. This long enough for it to get the fragrance. Shallots will get a little translucent. Now the flavors will really start to come together. Caramelized sausage on the bottom of it.
can so that the landscape flame press well. And you don't want to do this too long or too high because you don't want to burn the garlic. Just want just enough to get this free. Just let that sizzle for a little longer and we'll get onto our pasta. Let's collect about 1 cup of the pasta water because we're going to use this for our sauce. And the reason I don't use the pasta water is because it's got all that starch in there from the pasta. So we're going to reserve that to the side, and now we're going to drain our pasta. Get that all out there. And then we're just going to rinse the pasta with a little cool water. The reason we're doing this is when you rinse it with some cool water, that kind of pauses the cooking of the pasta, so this way it won't be too soggy after you're done. So you want to keep it at that al dente. Just some cool water over it, not too much. And we'll let that sit there. Now let's check on our onions, shallots. Yes, perfect. So let's go there. To this, we're going to add, comes together. We're going to add our half and half. Let's add our pumpkin sauce. Our pumpkin puree, actually. Third cup of grated Parmesan cheese. That reserved water that we kept to the side, I'm going to add that as well. Our sauce together. Depending on how creamy you want the sauce, you can always add additional like hot water, especially if you don't have any more of the pasta water left. You can just add hot water just to kind of loosen it up some. We'll let this simmer, come together. It's too creamy, we'll just add a little hot water to it. We're going to let that simmer, then we're going to salt it to taste, and then we'll bring the entire dish together. So now we'll just salt this to taste. We'll just add a little salt. Of course, you can always add a little more later. And we're going to pull this all together now. We're going to add our sausage to the sauce. And creamy, and we're just going to plate some of this here. that stuff. Sausage. You can just top that with a little Parmesan cheese if you like. A little parsley, fresh parsley. I like spice, you know, so a little red pepper flakes always does the trick. Voila! And we're all done. I hope you love it. Enjoy the rest of New York Foundling's Fall Fete. I'm gonna dig in.
Hi everyone, my name is Christina Charles and I'm a senior case planner from the Brooklyn office with the New York Foundling. I just had a great conversation with Bill Baccalini about our child welfare system. Please tune in on October 21st, 2020 to hear this great conversation. Thank you, hope you enjoy.